Is this how the rise of the planet of the apes really starts? While some monkeys have developed the ability to use stone tools, others have moved on to playing video games, thanks to a brain implant developed by Elon Musk's company Neuralink. Speaking via the exclusive Clubhouse app, the SpaceX and Tesla CEO explained that the device enabled a simian to play games using only its mind. But before going on to discuss how this is happening, make sure to subscribe to my channel so you never miss one of my videos. Headquartered in San Francisco, Neuralink's team of around 100 people is trying to develop an implementable computer brain interface that could allow people to interact with and control computers using nothing but their thoughts. The technology consists of a brain implant that can read the activity of neurons thanks to a series of electrodes and microscopic fibers. Last year, Musk demonstrated a prototype of the device that had been inserted into the brain of a pig whose neural activity was recorded and displayed on a screen. Musk and his team has now successfully created a wireless variant of the device, representing a major step forward for this technology. He explained that they have already got a monkey with a wireless implant in its skull, and he can play video games using its mind. One of the things they are trying to figure out is that can we have the monkeys play mind-Pong with each other? That would be pretty cool. It's not an unhappy monkey, he said. The billionaire, who also spoke about space travel, colonies on Mars, crypto, artificial intelligence, and COVID-19 vaccines, said Neuralink is trying to figure out if it can use its chips to get monkeys to play mind-Pong, the purpose of which is to create a direct neural interface that can improve the bandwidth between your cortex and your digital tertiary layer by many orders of magnitude. According to Musk, people are already in effect cyborgs because they have a tertiary digital layer thanks to phones, computers, and applications. Artificial intelligence is only going to get smarter, and Neuralink's technology could one day allow humans to go along for the ride. To illustrate the pace of progress in AI, the innovator, who believes that machine intelligence will eventually surpass human intelligence, pointed to breakthroughs made at research labs like OpenAI, which he co-founded, and DeepMind. DeepMind has run out of games to win at, basically. The cortex is a part of the brain that plays a key role in memory, attention, perceptual awareness, thought, language, and consciousness. The digital layer he refers could be anything from a person's iPhone to their Twitter account. Long term, Musk claims that Neuralink could allow humans to send concepts to one another using telepathy and exist in a saved cloud state after they die that could then be put into a robot or another human. Here we can all acknowledge that he was delving into sci-fi territory. In the near term, Musk wants to implant Neuralink chips into quadriplegics who have brain or spinal injuries so they can control a computer mouse or their phone or really any device just by thinking. The problem in today's world is the bandwidth between your brain and the digital world is very slow. In other words, our brains don't talk to computers fast enough. At a certain point, the computer gets smart enough that it's like the computer is like trying to talk to a tree. Brain's power is wasted in taking a thought, compressing it into few words, and communicating it to another person who must then decompress the words into a thought. But if the two people had a Neuralink, you could do conceptual telepathy where you have a complex series of concepts and you can just transfer them directly uncompressed to the other person, which would massively improve communication and the speed of it. The applications do in fact go murkier into the sci-fi territory. In all fairness, Musk's goals can seem amorphous and esoteric at times, and this concept is no exception. In response to a tweet, Musk claims to be in communication with the FDA. His implant could help a quadriplegic to control an electronic device just by thinking. He says it's sort of like a Fitbit in your skull with tiny wires that go to your brain, and that aligns with another vein, using Neuralink to stream music directly to your brain. Well, if Neuralink is really getting monkeys to, well, monkey around with the video games, that's seriously promising legwork towards those short-term goals. In any case, we will be patiently awaiting our first Pong match with a monkey. So friends, if you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.